as far as a good food plot strategy for small acre farms, whether it's 20, 40, 60, whatever you consider small, that varies by state, of course, as well. I own an 18 acre parcel. I learned, literally took me two seasons. I'm not afraid to admit that. It has two crop fields on it, both little bays. I left food on both sides. First year, both sides rocked. I had deer consistently come into both. As the crop rotation changed and some of the things changed in the neighborhood, this second season, almost 90% of my deer come from one neighbor. So strategically going forward, I'm obviously gonna put my food close to those as I can, staying on my own farm, of course, but I'm gonna move it to the bedding area the best I can. So if you own a 20, 40, 60, 80 acre tract, whatever it may be, don't just look at your own farm and say, well, this is my bedding area, the food needs to be right here. Because you may be walking by the best bedding area in the neighborhood on a neighbor that does hunt, maybe doesn't hunt at all, whatever the case may be. So make sure you look around, identify on your neighbors where you think the best bedding area is, the best deer are. CRP is a good one to look for, whether that's head high stuff, waist high stuff for good cover. Recently timbered ground holds a bunch of deer. And also just know that deer are gonna come from the neighbor, of course, and you may be better off to put it in an area on your farm. It doesn't suit you the best, but it suits you the best to hunt your neighbor's deer, and they come to you that way. So don't be afraid to look at that. A good time to do that is in the spring. It's mid-April right now. We can see a long ways. I can see onto the neighbor. You can tell my neighbor to the west here has had his timber cut. It's a lot thicker than ours. We just had ours cut. It'll thicken up over the next few years. And the neighbor to the west here, it looks like a park. So the deer aren't really gonna come from the west. We're gonna bank on them coming from the south. They're not gonna come from the east, rather, from the park looking stuff. They're gonna come from the south and from the west where the cover is. So keep that in mind, on especially on small acre tracts. When you put it in, putting in a food plot program, look around and look at the whole neighborhood. Don't just look at your little farm, get a bigger map, look at everything, and go from that angle. It'll serve you a lot better. Another food plot strategy I like to implement when I'm establishing a new plot, whether that's in an old pasture, a cedar patch, expired CRP, old tillable that just got too small for big equipment, and modern day equipment doesn't fit anywhere. So you'll find a lot of these little fallow fields. This is just a 1.75 acre, 2 acre type size field right here. And the shape was already here, so it was ideal. But I try to build a lot of my plots just like this one. There's a bay here and a bay here, and it kind of makes a kidney bean or a boomerang shape, horseshoe shape, if you will. That way the deer pinch down somewhere. Everybody that loves food plots wants big, bold, and bad, and so do I. I have some that are 4, 6, 8 acres. Those can get frustrating as well. You're over here, the deer's on the other end. If you're a diehard bow hunter, covering a 4 acre plot is tough. I mean, you can have 3, 4 stands around it, 2 blinds. It can look like an outdoor catalog when you're done with it, with everything that's around it. But if you build that to a certain shape, it'll pinch down a lot better for you. If you get that 50, 45, 40, even 30 yard kind of pinch, works out really well. I try to keep them in that 40-ish range. I don't like it too tight. You can't get a lot of does through. And a lot of times I've had them, I built them over the years when I first started 20 yards wide. Well, deer don't like to spend a lot of time right there, it seems. They kind of squirt through there, or they stay on both sides. And when they cross, they kind of get to it and they kind of do that little trot thing they do. I've learned over time, if you leave that about 40 yards, that's a good buffer. Generally they're halfway or so, so you're still a 20 yard shot. So try to keep that in consideration. But the shape of your food plot, if you're building it, is just as important as where it is and how you access it and everything else. That plays a key role. Don't go in there and think, well, I gotta blow out this whole 5 acre field of old pasture or whatever the case may be. Use it to your advantage to make it in that kidney bean or boomerang type shape, horseshoe shape. Horseshoe's a little sharp. I kind of like the boomerang shape, to be honest with you, if you can picture that. Just a subtle curve to it, and you're right in the curve. And where that makes the curve, I often like to block that with a bunch of blowdowns or whatever I cleared that with. I will make that obstacle there. Jokingly, years ago, Joe, a fellow agent, works in the office now with us. We hunted together in a big plot. It's 14 acres. I said one time, we need to run a fence from that tree 30 yards out, make them come around so we can hunt it, and he'd be right there. And I literally do that now, but not with fence, obviously. I use the manipulation of what I'm building, treetops, terrain. If you can manipulate one around the terrain, that helps a lot. but it just makes it so much easier. Because a lot of farms, you need that big food source to support all the deer, but covering it's tough, especially with a bow. So if you can use that pinch down in any way, shape, or form, do that. Just keep it in mind when you're building one or you're reclaiming a hay field like this, it's in an ideal shape. That's why we plant the whole thing. But if it was a big square, we probably wouldn't plant the whole thing. We'd kind of keep it in that boomerang shape and go from there.